So, or hmm, that's a joke. Did you get that joke, Megan? You got the joke. She's quiet today, which is an unusual thing for Megan. Here's how it works. If we have the HMM, so if we know the HMM, we know A and B and pi, we can use the forward algorithm and the backward algorithm, and this is part I'm not going to show you, to estimate, that's what's the cap E, the distribution of what state I'm likely to be in at time t, okay? Because one has to do with the sequences forward, one has to do with the sequences backward. I can evaluate the probability of all of the whole sequence. That allows me to estimate what's typically called gamma I of t, the probability that I'm in state one at time t, state two, state three, all right? I estimate that distribution. Well, if you give me that distribution, and I've actually seen at every time t what was observed, then given the likelihood that I'm in each of the states, probability that I'm in each of the states, and the observed data, I can figure out what the most likely B sub J of K. That is, what do I think the emission probabilities are? And I pick the ones that would maximize the total observation probability. It's no different than saying maximum likelihood, you know, if I'm drawing something and I pull, you know, I pull 10 things out and 7 of them are black and 3 are red, I say there's a 70% chance of being black. That value is the one that would have maximized the likelihood of pulling out 7 of them. It's a maximization procedure. So I can choose the B sub K's that maximize the total observation given those probability, the idea of which state I'm in, okay? Also, given that distribution, I can also say, well, if I think there's a 75% chance that I'm in state one at this time and a 90% chance that I'm in state two at the next time, that tells me that, well, you know, the likelihood of going from one to two must be kind of high, right? And basically by looking over all of time and looking at my guess about the states, I can come up with the best possible transition probabilities. And when I say best, the ones that maximize the probability. That gives me my new AIJs, and I've got new BKs. I can also guess new pis, but those never matter. That's my new machine, right? So after I do the M step, called the maximization step, of getting the new A's and B's, I now have a new machine. I can go back and do the E step again. I can estimate the probabilities of being in a particular state at time T, and I redo that process. And that iterative process, it's called expectation maximization. The particular algorithm for HMMs was called the Baum-Welch algorithm. Like I said, there's plenty of tutorials out there for you to look at it. The fundamental idea is that by using these recursive algorithms and then estimating the probability of being at a particular state at a particular time, I can re-estimate the machine.